Hello, everybody, and welcome back to another episode of Microsoft Flight Simulator. And you are definitely going to want to watch this video in its entirety. Please do not skip ahead through any of the portions of this video, as if you do, you may very likely miss critical steps that will impact your ability to complete all of the information that is in this video. I will be going over three different sections, you guys. We will be talking first about shader cache and an awesome tool that I think I have created that will help you clear the shader cache much, much easier than what you normally have to do. I will also be talking about antivirus and the importance of adding exclusions. And then finally, we will be talking about the different versions of DLSS and what they could mean for you. There will be chapters in this video on every section. Again, please do your best not to skip ahead on any portion of it. I will do my best to be as succinct and quick as possible while making sure to deliver all the required information to complete all the steps that are involved. So, without further delay, let's get started. If you are interested in acquiring any of my Overkill's tutorial guides for Microsoft Flight Simulator, or simply interested in supporting the channel, please consider joining us on Patreon. Patreon subscribers level tier 2 and above have access to all of my guides, as well as any future releases that come down the road. Patreon link can be found in the description below. Okay, so as I have recently completed all of the steps that I have included in this guide, I had to reset everything. So we're up flying around LAX to generate some shader cache. We'll be using LAX as our test bed, if you will. Please take a note of the frame rate. You guys can see it's bouncing around between 20 and 30, and this is also very normal. So let me give you guys some expectations on completing all of the steps that I have in this guide. First off, let's talk about shader cache. Shader cache will not necessarily increase performance. Completing the steps in regard to shader cache should, very much so though, help in reducing stuttering. Now, as we all say, even as I put on this ultimate FPS and performance guide, right? There is no one-stop shop, guys. All of our systems are different. We all have different pieces of software. We all have different pieces of hardware. We all have different pieces of third-party applications that may be running in the background that could be impacting performance. So please set your expectations accordingly. These, at the end of the day, as much as we like to do the clickbait, and it's not really clickbait, it's just to get you excited about the information we're providing. But as much as we like to post all that, there is no one fix will work for absolutely everybody, okay? Outside of, did you turn your computer on, okay? So with that in mind, I want to make sure again to set those expectations accordingly, that any of this could change for you in the good way, or it may not do much at all. It really depends on what your particular scenario is. Things I want you guys to pay attention to is the main thread here, as that is something that I have noticed was impacted by completing the steps that I provided in the guide. The next expectation that I want you guys to be aware of, and it's even included in the tool that I have created, is that the first time you launch back into the sim, as I have just done here, you will initially notice longer load times, and you will notice some intense stuttering and possibly frame rate loss, as you guys are seeing on the screen right now, the first time you load it, as all of the shader files that we have removed will have to be recreated. So on your first initial run for the first few minutes, and few minutes is subjective. It again depends on hardware, software, internet performance, all that good thing. All that jazz is going to come into play here on whether or not you're going to have a smooth experience quickly, or whether it may take 15, 20 minutes of flying around before you start noticing an improvement. Okay, it all depends on how long it takes for those shader files to be recreated. All right, so with that in mind, again, remember that there are chapters to each section that will be down in the description below, as well as on the time bar if you guys want to click on those to get to a particular point. And also, as regard to the script that I have written, This is the important part. The first section is probably the most important, as if you guys miss a step on that, the script that I have created will not work. But it will be available for download on my Patreon site if you guys are interested. No, you do not have to pay me for it. It is just a batch file. It will be available for free. However, if you'd like to help me out in creating future things like this, I would absolutely appreciate a subscription. It definitely helps the channel out beyond words from what I can describe. You guys who support me on Patreon have made so much more possible than I ever thought was going to be possible, as well as you guys here on YouTube. All of you guys contribute to my development and contribute to my lifestyle, and I can't even express my gratitude. I am a father and provider of a family of five, so again, I cannot express my gratitude enough. So this is just one way that I was trying to help out, and I hope you appreciate it. The other thing I will be doing after completing all of the steps that I have here is, over the next couple days, I will be developing a PDF tutorial guide on what I do, screenshot by screenshot, to keep my sim running as smooth as I can. All right. Now, also take a note at the frame rate and the main thread. Look it. This is exactly what you could expect to see after a few minutes. Remember, this was all red a minute ago. The frame rate was down into the low 20s at points, and now we are maintaining mid 30s, and you can see that the main thread limitation is not near as red as it was previously. Okay, so that is what we want to see, and that's the kind of improvement that you guys can expect to see when this is all said and done. So without any further delay, let's now get into the troubleshooting, if you will, or the steps required, and we will begin with shader cache. All right, so here is the part where I talk very, hopefully slowly, but I will not jabber on. This is the tool that I have created that we will get into in just a minute. Again, the first thing that we are going to be dealing with is our shader cache. So the very first thing that we need to do is, actually, I need to close down a couple of applications. Bear with me because I don't want them up and running while we're doing this. Okay, it closed. Good. Looks like SPED was the only one. So the first thing that we are going to do is we're going to open up our NVIDIA control panel. From the NVIDIA control panel, you need to be in global settings, as this is where this setting resides. And we will be looking for shader cache size. This is critical, okay? We need to click on it, and we need to go to disabled. At the point we hit disabled, we need to then hit apply. And at this moment right here, I want you to restart your computer. Do nothing else afterwards, simply restart and come back to me. All right, now that we have disabled our shader cache, the next thing that we're going to do is talk about the different folders that we typically go into delete shader cache. And to do that, I'm going to show you guys, this is my tool right here. And it is just a batch file. There's nothing crazy about it. But what we're going to do is we're going to right click, and I'm going to do is edit with Notepad++. But if you don't have Notepad++, you can simply use Notepad. All Windows machines have Notepad on it. So I would not use WordPad, use Notepad. WordPad can actually inadvertently break certain scripts. So just because it uses rich format text. So Notepad, not WordPad. But if you don't have Notepad++, I do recommend getting it, as it lays everything out very, very nicely, and it will recognize this immediately as a batch file. So we're going to open that up, and here it is. Here's my batch file. So the biggest thing, don't worry about this. This is all, you guys will see all of this later. But these are the files and directories, if you will, that you need to go to. Okay, now, the part that you guys are all going to need to change, okay, whether you grab this from Patreon or you make this yourself, you need to find this directory. Mine says Overkill. Okay, now, many of you may not know how to find who you currently are logged in as, and that's totally fine, okay, especially if you're on a machine that has multiple users. So what you're interested in is the user profile that you are logged into right now as you are watching this. I'm assuming that it's the same profile you use to fly your simulators and play your games. Also, keep in mind that these steps will impact every game you play that uses shader cache, which is most of them these days. Whether it's Microsoft Flight Simulator, American Truck Simulator, DCS World, those are just to name a few that absolutely use shader cache. All right, so let's do this. first to determine this name right here. How do I know what name I'm supposed to do? So let's start the directory and I'll show you guys what I'm talking about. And of course it opened it on the wrong monitor. Get over here. So we're going to go to C and we're going to go to users. Now you can see you have default. There's my overkill and you have public here. That's most people will see. However, again, if you're on a machine that has multiple users on it where multiple profiles have been created, there may be quite a few here. So how do you know which one is yours? What I want you guys to do is simply right click on your start menu and go to Windows PowerShell or Windows Command Prompt, whichever one you have. You don't have to use elevated. I just always do, which is the admin one. And you're going to type something very simple, all in one word, who am I? Press enter. And there it is, right there, it says overkill. And there's the corresponding overkill. All right, so now what we're going to do is we're going to follow that directory. We're going to go to, I'm just going to show you guys the first one manually, the rest will copy and paste so you can see them all. We're going to go overkill. We're going to go into app data. We're going to go to local low. We're going to go to NVIDIA. And then per driver version. NDX cache, and this is always going to be the big one, bam. I believe both DirectX 11 and DirectX 12 stores their shader cache here, so it shouldn't matter which one you're on. This is where those will be. Now, let's find these remaining directories. The next one, GL cache. I believe OpenGL is another method similar to DirectX that is used for storing shader cache. I'm not sure what software specifically use it. I believe in certain cases, virtual reality does. But I'm not 100% positive on that. So I'm going to paste that in, press enter. Whoa, what are you talking about? Oh, that folder doesn't exist. It's because I've already cleared it. So let's do this. NVIDIA. Okay, so I'm going to do this. Go to new folder, and we're just going to type it. This is just for example. You guys do not have to do this part. Again, another reason why it's important that you guys follow my instructions step by step. I'm just showing you guys as an example. New folder or new text document, and we're just going to call this test because all this should do is remove the contents of the folder. Okay, so there it is, GL cache. So we got that one, and there's our test file. Like I said, I've already did this. I did have a few files in here when I did this for the first time this morning, but clearly whatever I've done with Microsoft Flight Simulator, I've used both DirectX 11 and DirectX 12 to create new shader caches in here, but neither one of those used the GL cache. So I did have a few in there, but it wasn't very many. Next one. This one is a cool one that I'm going to save you guys a few steps on by doing this script. We're going to come in here again, do a paste, enter. There we go. So these files here, okay, let's talk about this. Remember, I wanted to talk to you guys about where all of this is coming from. So these files here are the same thing that you would do if you did disk cleanup. So in all the videos you guys have watched, including a couple of my own, what do we always say? At the very end, make sure you come into disk cleanup, go to OK, and delete the DirectX shader cache, 50 megs, okay? You guys can see right here, okay? This is the same thing. If we back up one and go to properties, 50 megs, okay? It's the exact same folder. So this is the exact same location. So now what I've done is I've removed the need for you guys to come in here and do this. You no longer have to do this, okay? So we're gonna close that for a minute, but we'll open it after we've completed our script. And finally, the last one here, open this up. I'm going to grab all of this and we're just going to go to the directory. And control C. And there's that file right there. This is the rolling cache. Every other video that you guys have ever seen, what do they tell you to do? Launch Microsoft Flight Simulator, go into your data, find rolling cache, turn it off, and then hit delete rolling cache, right? Well, this is saving the step of turning it off. And then what do you have to do? You have to close the sim down. You have to launch it back up, you know, after a restart. And then you have to turn your rolling cache back on. This will delete the rolling cache file. This is where the rolling cache file inside of Microsoft Flight Simulator is stored. So now We have seen everything that we need to do in order to properly execute this script. Once you have changed your username, make sure that you save it. You should not need to change anything else. Okay? Nothing else. You shouldn't need to adjust anything else. Okay? We'll talk about this stuff in just a minute as an option if you guys want to. But that's all you need to do. The only requirement that you must do is change where it says overkill to the username that we discovered earlier by typing who am I. Okay? All right. So now let's execute the script. So I'm going to try to organize these in a way where we can all see them a bit better. Okay. Monitor that one. Monitor this one. And this one. Now, what those top lines are in the script that I was showing you guys is a couple of messages that will pop up. So we're going to double click this. Since you have just executed this bat file and I don't want you wasting your time, I have a couple of things to remind you of. Did you disable the shader cache in NVIDIA control panel? Yes, we did that. Okay, remember to restart. If no, then do that now and run this again. I will change this message to say, if no, then do that now and restart your computer, okay? Okay, if yes, press any key in the window displayed and be sure to restart the computer and don't forget to turn the NVIDIA shader cache back on. All right, remember, when you first start your sim and other games, you will likely see a slower load time and lower performance for a few minutes. As new shader files are being generated for the first time, this is normal. Happy gaming. So we're gonna hit okay. I'm gonna come right here. Let me bring this down a bit so we can see everything. And I'm gonna hit enter and enter again. And there you go. All of your shader cache is now officially emptied. It literally deleted everything. Okay, so I hope you guys really thought that was cool. The last step that we need to do here is simply restart the computer. Okay, so we have now restarted. Everything is done. Remember, the first step that we need to do coming back to it is we need to go back into NVIDIA control panel. And we are going to come down to shader cache size. And you can either leave it as driver default or you can set it to something higher if you wish. I normally use 100 gigs. I will hit apply. But again, that depends on your hard drive. If you don't have a ton of space on your C drive, specifically the C drive, do not bump that too high. Okay. All right. So we'll go ahead and now close the window. That's done. We're done with the NVIDIA control panel. And now let's talk about final thoughts here before we relaunch the simulator and talk about things. First off, let's talk about the directories that we included inside of the script. All of the directories that you see here, minus the overkill, this will be your username. This should be different. But everything else, unless you have a computer or profile named overkill, but everything else about these directories should be the exact same. It should not matter where you got your SIM from. It shouldn't matter if it's Steam, shouldn't matter if it's MSFS Store or Microsoft Store, should not matter. If you are on a Windows machine, everything here should be the same. Okay. Oh, and on an NVIDIA card. Now this one will be, these two will be the same regardless, whether you are on AMD or NVIDIA. These two will obviously only exist if you are using an NVIDIA card. If you're using an AMD graphics card, I do not know. I would suggest looking in a similar location and find something that is similar. That again, I cannot say where these are for AMD cards. I'm not sure where they get their DirectX from. If it's still NVIDIA, I'm not positive, okay? So if you're on an AMD video card, these might be different. I'm not sure. And by the way, if you don't know, AMD is also Radeon, so same thing, all right? So those are the only two caveats. Now, the last thing, the pop-ups that came up at the beginning of launching it, you know, all these messages, if you guys recognize these, okay? And by the way, let me do something here. Did you disable shader cache from the NVIDIA shader cache? And I'm going to do shader cache size. Clarify that. If no, then do that now and restart your computer. There we go. And if yes, be sure to restart the computer. Yep. Okay. You're good. All right. Everything else is good. So I'm just going to hit save. So the same thing right there. Just like I just did, I just clicked save. You're going to edit this username right here and click save. But if you guys don't want all of these messages to come up, you can literally take everything that I've highlighted here from pause up to the top and delete it. Okay, and then hit save. And by doing so, you will not get the press any key to continue. When you double click the batch file, it will just execute. Okay, it will just clear it. So you, by if you remove this, you won't get the press any key to continue. It'll just go. If you want the press any key to continue, just take out everything here between at echo off and pause. Leave this line and this line in there and you'll get the prompt. Okay? If you guys like that. So, and that is basically it for this. Let's go ahead and relaunch the simulator. All right, as we get back into the sim, the other thing we need to remember to do is turn rolling cash back on if you use it. Now, if you have a high speed internet connection, I mean high speed, you are very confident, it is very good, you do not need to turn it on. But make sure that you do, just in case. If you disabled it. Remember I told you that an advantage of the way that I did things was that you did not have to. So just if you are someone who uses it and you did disable it, make sure you turned it back on. Okay. All right. And I can just hit cancel here. Oh, discard. Excuse me. No, whatever. I didn't change anything, you putz. Anyway, let's go back. All right. So now you're going to see the frame rates bounce around quite a bit. Main thread's going to be busy for a while. This is the part that I was telling you guys about earlier that is to be expected. Everything's going to be running a little crappy now. I took off very early. I'm not paying attention to my flying at all. My goal here is to just demonstrate the shader cache. So let's do a real quick recap and make sure that if you're at my point and you're back in the sim, we followed everything. So from the start of it, we disabled shader cache size in the NVIDIA control panel. We then restarted our computer. We then launched the script and watched it clear or let it do its thing as it cleared all the shader cache files. The D3DS shader cache, which is, by the way, you no longer have to use disk cleanup in order to remove the DirectX shader cache in Windows. So that covers that. And we deleted our rolling cache. Then we once again restarted the computer. We then turned shader cache size file back on in the NVIDIA control panel. Make sure that we turned it back on. We then, if you manually disabled it for any reason, launched the simulator and you re-enabled rolling cache if you're using it. Again, rolling cache is usually used for flyers with lower than ideal internet connections. Okay, and then you now are flying and you are experiencing exactly what I'm experiencing here. You're going to experience a lot of stutters. You're going to experience a lot of lag spikes. You're going to experience very low frame rate for a second and inconsistent frame rate while the shader cache folders are being regenerated. Okay, so we're just gonna fly around for a few minutes. All right, so that took about 6 minutes. I was just sort of doing a loop around the area, around the airport, and you guys can now see what the frame rates look like now. Okay, so I gained between 4 and 8, maybe call it 10, 12 frames per second, depending on where I'm at and what I'm doing. But the biggest thing is, look at the main thread, okay? Notice that now I'm no longer seeing red. I'm still seeing limited by main thread, but I'm not seeing the peaking anymore. There's one right there, a couple here and there, but nothing like it was before, okay? And that is the biggest thing that we're looking for, okay? It's not that you're gonna get a huge frame rate gain. What you're looking for is consistency. You're looking for a smoother experience. If you watch the terrain out the windows, notice that it's not lagging anymore. It's not sticking anymore. We're not seeing any more jolts, okay? Where before it was epically bad, okay? So let's bring it all the way back down. Again, I am not concerned about how my flying is right now. We are sort of just winging everything. Let's just see if it gets any worse as we get lower and lower. Remember, we were down to the teens down on the runway. It was bouncing anywhere from 17, 15, up to about peaking at about 21, occasionally hitting the 30s, but that really, I'm not counting that because that certainly was not consistent while we were down on the ground. This, by the way, do not do this approach. This is a terrible approach. This is a space shuttle landing. Holy crap. Which, is, again, if you've been watching my channel for a while, I do those a lot, but not usually this steep. At least the Comanche slows down like crazy. And let's bleed it. Hold it. We're definitely going to float for a minute. Nice squeaking. And look at the frame rates, guys. Still right where they were when we were on the when we were up in the air. So that is what you should expect to see. I did not see necessarily a huge frame rate increase in comparison to what I was before. What I'm seeing now is much more stable frame rate. I'm seeing much more consistent frame rate. The stuttering around LA normally for me is awful, you guys. It is terrible. So, again, let's talk about one more time what the tool does and the steps you need to take. With the tool, you need to make sure to change the username in it using Notepad or Notepad++, or if whether you write it yourself or you download it from Patreon. On Patreon site, it will be free. It will come in a zip file. You will need to extract it. If you would like to support me and my work, thank you. If not, no worries. But make sure you change the username in it using Notepad or Notepad++. Do not use WordPad, okay? If you write your own and you just copy it and as you saw it typed and you write your own, make sure when you do File, Save As, select All Files, name it what you want, but at the end of the name, type .bat, Bravo Alpha Tango for bat. Otherwise, it will simply save it as a standard text file and it won't do anything. Okay? So, those are the big keys there. Now, what does it do? It clears the DirectX shader cache. It clears the OpenGL shader cache. It clears the Windows shader cache, meaning that you no longer need to do the disk cleanup. Okay? And it deletes the rolling cache file. Order of operation. You need to first go open in video control panel, disable the shader cache size in the global settings. Make sure you set it to disabled. Remember what its current setting is if you want to set it back to what it is. Then you will restart your computer immediately after disabling shader cache size. Then you will run the script, let it do its thing. Then you will restart your computer again. Then you will open up in video control panel and you will be sure to re-enable the shader cache size in the global settings with whatever the setting was that either you prefer or whatever it was. Remember, whatever size you set it to, it could potentially be used up. So make sure that you have the hard drive space to accommodate whatever size you select comfortably. Okay, if you only have 100 gigs left free on your hard drive, on the C drive specifically, the C drive, I would not set it to say 80 gigs. Okay, I would keep it down lower. If you have a terabyte free, sure, go for it. That's what I have, and that's why I set mine to 100 gigs. All right, and then you will launch the simulator. Once you've launched the simulator, you will fly around a specific area. Expect crappy performance for anywhere from 5. It could be all the way up to a half an hour or longer, depending on internet speed connection, hardware, and software running around the computer in the background. And suddenly, guys, what will happen is if after 20 minutes you are not seeing any change whatsoever, everything's exactly as it was, I would recommend closing the simulator and restarting it. I have not had to do this, but if you do run into that, restart it and see if the shader cat, if when you go back into the sim, everything's nice and smooth. You should definitely see it eventually, but it may take a while. I cannot speak to everyone's machine. And finally, the last point that I want to remind everyone is of, this is not a one-stop shop fix all. You're going to absolutely see amazing performance. It is a tip. It is an aid. It is something that, yes, should absolutely help, but may not resolve your issue if the shader cache is not what's causing your problem. Remember that third-party softwares, third-party recordings, third-party audios, there's all kinds of things that can cause stuttering. Anything that interrupts Microsoft Flight Simulator or that takes a high demand on your CPU or GPU that may be running in the background. For example, right now I am losing a few frames simply by having OBS open and recording the display. All right, so that is going to wrap up shader cache. Now let's talk about antivirus and exclusions. All right, so our next step here is to talk about antivirus and exclusions. As we talked about briefly in the beginning of this video, antiviruses are constantly scanning files and folders with inside of your computer looking for threats, especially any file or folder that's being actively processed at any given time, or new files like shader cache that are being implemented or developed. So what we want to do, and again, this step is for Windows Defender. Anybody should have Windows Defender if you are running a Windows machine. However, if you have Windows Defender disabled, then you probably know that, as I said earlier. And if you're using a third-party antivirus, such as AVG, McAfee, or Norton, or many of the others, Symantec, you will need to know how to add exclusions in that particular piece of software. So with that stated, let's go ahead and get started here. So the first thing that you're going to want to do is open up your start menu and simply type virus. And you'll find virus and threat protection. Come down here. And we are going to go to virus and threat protection settings, manage settings. We're going to scroll all the way down to the bottom. And you are looking for exclusions. Add or remove an exclusion. Now you guys can see here that I've already added quite a few here. So, first thing, I will remove all of the Microsoft Flight Simulator ones so that way you guys can see them for yourselves. I even did my recordings folder in OBS so it doesn't affect my OBS. Pimax, OpenXR, you guys can use the same thing. These are all DCS. So, let's run through a few of these. Now, by the way, if you do not feel comfortable, if you are concerned in any way, shape, or form that you may get a virus, say, in the community folder, if you downloaded a third-party mod from a, say, not-so-accurate site, or you're worried about a shader cache somehow becoming a virus, I will never say nothing is possible when it comes to software. There are people who will exploit just about anything. Okay, I work in IT. I have my own security system outside of the computer here that also helps preventing things like this. So I am comfortable doing this. Do not complete any of these steps if you are not completely comfortable exposing those particular folders. All right, let's continue on with that in mind. So the first thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to add an extension. I'm going to add an exclusion. I'm going to add a folder. From inside the folder, the first thing I'm doing is going to add my Microsoft Flight Simulator folder. Now, the packages. This is where my community and official folder are, but this is not necessarily the EXE. So I'm going to go add-ons. This is all where my add-ons are. This is where all my applications are for Microsoft Flight Simulator. This is where my community and my official store folders are. I'm going to add this directory right here. I don't want anything inside of this directory to be scanned. I do it myself independently. So I'm going to hit select folder. Then I'm going to actually add my shader cache folders. Okay. I don't want the shader cache files being scanned by the antivirus, further reducing any possibility of those being retrieved quickly. One of the things that essentially you don't want to ever see, if you guys have ever opened up a file or a folder and it says this file or folder is currently being used by another program, I don't want that to ever happen with my shader cache. But again, only do this if you're comfortable. So I'm going to go to folder, and we're going to go back to those directories that we mentioned before. To do so, I think I'm just going to open up our bat file to get those directories quickly. I'll just move this over here. I'm going to hit C. Boom, there we go. Pop that guy in there. I'm going to back up one, select the DX cache, and hit select folder. I'm going to add another folder. And the next one, I believe, is in local, yep. So I'm going to come back to local. And we're again looking for NVIDIA. Where's my NVIDIA? There it is. And it actually removed that particular folder. So in this particular situation, I'm going to just simply add the NVIDIA folder. Again, you are not required to do this. And finally, I am going to add the D3DS cache again. Only do this if you're comfortable. I'm going to keep repeating that no matter how many times. It is a very personal choice, and you have to be very confident in your ability to protect your computer anytime that you are doing this. So I'm going to go back, and I'm simply going to select the cache folder and hit select folder. Okay, and finally, the last thing that I want is a process. Sorry, the recording got cut off there. The last thing that I'm going to do is add the exclusion for the actual process of Flight Simulator. So here, if you guys open up your task manager, my simulator is currently closed, so it won't show at the moment. So you would right click on your toolbar, go to task manager. Darn it, get over here. Go to details and you can see a list of everything that is currently running in your machine. If you do not see all of this, then on this window, you probably see something that, oh, here, I'll show you. If you see this window, you don't see anything else. You just see more details. Click more details. Go to details. Hit here, hit F on your keyboard and you should see Flight Simulator. If the simulator is running, the simulator must be running. If the simulator is not running, you will not see Flight Simulator. Okay, so with that in mind, this is what you would normally see when the sim is running if you want to double check yourself. To add the exclusion, we're going to go to Add Exclusion, Process, and exactly as you see it there on the screen is what we're going to type. FlightSimulator.exe. It must be exact. If there is any difference, then it may still add the exclusion, but it won't do a thing for you. So hit add, and at the bottom, we can now see flightsimulator.exe as a process that has been added, which will also be excluded from the antivirus, which means that the antivirus is no longer going, currently the way I have this set, flightsimulator.exe will no longer scan any of my add-ons. It will not scan any of my packages or apps, anything that's in there, the folder specifically, and it will not run against the Flight Simulator process itself. That does not mean that there are not any Flight Simulator folders that will be scanned. There are a bunch of Microsoft Flight Simulator files inside of the Windows Apps folder. I will not be discussing that because it requires you basically changing the security permissions with inside of Windows in order to access that directory, and I don't feel comfortable showing that here on YouTube. If you do something wrong in that particular directory, you can break your entire machine. So there are some things that may still be impacted, but we've done a pretty good job here of limiting what the antivirus can see, what it's allowed to play with, essentially. Okay, so the next thing that I'm going to do is we're going to relaunch the sim and see if it made any difference. And by the way, again, we may not see any difference. This is simply a tip and a way of alleviating potential things that could. So the last thing that we are going to be talking about again is DLSS. But the first thing that I do recommend, and this is a very helpful tool for any of your GPU needs, is to follow the link below and look for a tool called GPUZ. GPUZ, much like CPUZ, is a tool that monitors specifically everything there is just about in regard to your video card. So I'm just going to click this first version. I am then going to double click it and get it installed. Yep, that's fine. Just asking if I want to add a shortcut to the start menu. There's a default directory. Create desktop shortcut, sure. I don't normally do shortcuts, but showing it in its simplicity. And launch it. All right, so this is an incredibly powerful program. It literally tells you just about everything there is to know and many other things outside of what you need to know for your video card and your motherboard in general. It gives us our current driver version that we're running. It gives us our current memory size, the type of DDR that's being used, you name it. It tells you all kinds of goody stuff. Okay, but what we're interested is we're going to be using it to find our current DLSS version that exists with inside of it. So once we have this part, by the way, I want to give a big shout out once again to Island Sim Pilot. This particular piece of information I got completely from him, and this was beautiful as far as using the GPU-Z for this particular process. But go to Advanced, go to NVIDIA DLSS, search DE or CE and V, whatever your drives are, and we're going to hit Start Scan. And it will tell you where all of your DLSS files are. So there's Eagle Dynamics. And these are the ones that honestly we need to avoid. So what I'm going to do is we're going to talk about these two, because in order to manually update, if you were going to do it manually, meaning going to the folder to do it. So you can see actually, we are currently showing two different DLSS files in Microsoft Flight Simulator. There's 2.4 and there's 3.51, but this one is frame generation. So as long as you're on a 4080 card and you have frame generation enabled, which I believe I do with inside of Microsoft Flight Simulator, we shouldn't have any problems. The older, if we're not using frame gen, so any sim that isn't using frame gen is using currently 2.4. So we're going to go ahead and at least change this one so I can show you guys the process. Again, if it's in the Windows app, this directory, you guys can, and I will have a link to the space where you can download it. This is right here, the NVIDIA DLSS 3.51 for frame generation. I will have a link to this location down in the description below. However, I will not be showing how to manually change that on here. Again, I cannot stress enough, as it requires you to manually change the security settings on the Windows app directory, which I will be happy to show you guys so you guys know what I'm talking about. I have done it in the past. I don't need to right now, but you go to Program Files. It's a hidden folder, so if you need to go view, make sure that hidden items is checked if you can't see it. But watch, if you try to open it, you get a security error. There is a way to get past this. I know how to do it. I just won't share it, because if you do it wrong, again, there is a chance that you could literally break your entire machine. Okay, so keep that in mind. All right, but as far as the rest of everything goes, I will also have a link in the description to the DLSS Swapper. Okay, this is a really cool tool that, once again, Island Sim Pilot showed us a long time ago. I had not known about it until then, but here's what the program looks like. Now here you can see DLSS. You can see 2.4.1.2. The other thing about 40 series cards is they are able to natively handle frame generation, meaning that they do not need a specific software driver. In this case, the DLL for Microsoft Flight Simulator, they should not need one in order to do frame generation. So for those of you who say, nope, you can't, you have to do the frame, that is not necessarily true. Now, that is my understanding of it. If I'm wrong, by all means, please don't just say you're wrong, you're full of crap, Mike, learn, go do your research. If I'm wrong, please post a link down in the description showing where I am wrong so I can read it and back you guys up and show you the same link. Okay, if you simply just say, nope, Mike, you're absolutely wrong, you're full of crap, I'm probably just going to delete your comment. Okay, all right, I'm trying to help people. So if you think I'm wrong, tell me and tell me why. All right, anyway, so what I'm going to do is I'm still going to update the non-frame generation DLL to 3.51, and I'm going to simply hit swap. Now, I believe we are about to see an error, which is what I want you guys to see. There we go. Please download the DLSS record. That's probably the only part where this is a little unintuitive. Okay, you have to come over here to the library first. Library is the library of all the DLSS's that you currently have. So we're just going to download it from here first. Okay, once that's in, then we'll go back over here. Then we'll go to Microsoft Flight Simulator. Then we'll select 3.5 and we'll hit swap. And there you go. And that's it. So this is for the non-frame generation specific DLL. If you are on a 40 series card, you should not have to update the DLL. It should have been done automatically. And if you guys saw when we did the GPU-Z scan, is that still up? Yes, it is. Here it is. You guys can see 3.51. It is already there, an FG for frame generation. So we shouldn't have to update that particular one. However, the other one did. Now, if we run this search again, you can now see both of them are on 3.51. Okay, and we can just hit close now. We're done there. So the final step here is we will launch the simulator one more time and see if we've seen any massive difference or change, or just exit with a cool plane flying in the air shot. But let's see what we got and we'll go from there. All right, so we are back in the sim and now you guys can see that we're getting about where we were. I went ahead and mixed things up a little bit and we switched to the Just Flight Piper Arrow. And again, hanging out over LA, right back to where we were, getting about similar frames. So again, very consistent. Main thread usage is about the same, a little higher this time around. And that could be, again, for a plethora of reasons. But frame rate, that's the big one, is staying relatively consistent. Now, the last thing I want to talk to you guys about is frame generation if you're on a 40 series card and how to make sure that is enabled. Now, this is something you'll have to test with, guys, because I've had mixed results. Okay, sometimes it goes better, sometimes not so much. Notice that NVIDIA DLSS frame generation. This is what will force the use of the frame generation DLL. Notice that it is grayed out. It is because hardware accelerated, or HAGS as we call it, hardware accelerated GPU scheduling is disabled on my machine. The biggest reason why it's disabled is because I also fly in DCS World, and DCS World hates HAGS, absolutely despises HAGS. Okay, but in order to use it, I will show you guys how to activate it or check if it's on. So you open up, you right click on your desktop, open up display settings, come here and look for advanced displays, or excuse me, nope, they moved it. It is now in graphics settings. Go to graphics settings and there it is, hardware accelerated GPU scheduling. In order to use it, you have to restart your computer for the changes to take effect. Okay, so even if I do that, notice that it is still grayed out. We would have to reboot and test again. So that may be something that I do. But again, the reason why I'm not showing that is because this is one that I absolutely, and I have seen it change from update to update. Sometimes it's great. Sometimes it causes problems. Sometimes it's great with VR. Sometimes it causes problems. Like DCS especially, the biggest thing is in VR. VR specifically, I have found with DCS World, it hates HAGS. I cannot play it with HAGS turned on. You turn HAGS on, you can crank your settings in DCS World all the way down to super low, the absolute lowest, and you turn on VR and it's still just stuttering like crazy. Frame rates are crap. You turn HAGS off and it runs beautifully. Okay, so it really depends on the application. I try as best I can to not use HAGS. Again, the biggest reason is because in order to use it, you have to reboot. So if I fly Microsoft Flight Simulator, I would have it on, and then I would want to fly DCS World. I would forget that I had it on, and then I would have to turn around and do it again. And reboot everything and relaunch the sim, blah, blah. So really it comes down to laziness. I just don't like having to restart the computer. So anyways, guys, I hope you have found this video useful, and I hope that you remember once again that there is no one setting that fixes all. These steps may help you a lot, and they may not do very much. I really do hope that they've at least, you know, given you some insight and give you some things to try and think about to improve your performance in Microsoft Flight Simulator and other games as well. Remember, the shader cache thing works for every sim and game just about that's out there in some shape or form or other. So it could help you across the board in multiple platforms and not just Microsoft Flight Simulator. For example, the next time that, speaking of, that I load into DCS World, I should have to go through all the same thing. It will run like crap for the first few minutes that I'm in there, and after that, I may see an improvement in stability more than anything else. It's not a big FPS gain, as you guys see here. Right now, I'm getting just about what I always get, but the limited by main thread is much smoother. I'm not seeing near as much red, and so therefore the stability and the smoothness of the sim has definitely improved since I started this process this morning. All right. Anyways, guys, once again, I hope you enjoyed the video. Be sure to hit that like and subscribe button. If you did, share the video with other people who might find this interesting. It helps me out a lot. If you're interested in joining me on Patreon, thank you so much. I really do appreciate the support. And as always, stay safe and healthy. I'll see you in the next one.